Good evening, St. Thomas More family. It's Father Browning's weekly update. And so we have some kind of exciting news to share. Yesterday, we received some communication from the diocese and from the bishop as they've been working with the state of Illinois to get us back to the sacraments, right? And so this first kind of phase that we'll be in will allow us to begin public masses again on May 25th. Of course, we'll adhere to the current number of attendees being 10. And, you know, we'll be prepared to probably add a mass or so a day and some masses on the weekend to get a few more people through receiving the sacraments again, receiving Jesus in the Eucharist and such. And it's exciting, but also we're awaiting the further instructions from the diocese on how to set this up and implement it. Make sure it's doable, that everybody is safe. We want to get people back to the sacraments, but also make sure that their safety is taken care of, their health is taken care of. So obviously we'll adhere to all the social distancing rules, to wearing masks, and we're gonna go through all that and create a plan so that we're ready to go whenever that May 25th comes. So just something for you to pray about too. To please pray for us as we plan this. It's amazing the amount of planning goes into to Mass now when it comes to 10 people and when you have a parish of 2,500 families. So a lot of work to be done on our end. So please pray for us, and we'll be seeking some volunteers in different ways, which they'll receive training and such. So if you're of the age where it's a little bit safer for you to be out and around, adhering to the, of course, guidelines that are set out for us by the state, by the CDC and such. Maybe think about how if you would be willing to volunteer in a role. We're going to try to develop and train all of those volunteers with the different aspects that will go into preparing for those masses. But we're working on all the details, which the diocese is going to give us some more information on that as well. I just wanted you to know that it's on the horizon and that we can begin to pray for that, pray for guidance of the Holy Spirit to prepare us for this. And also to be, we'll continue to live stream a Mass each day so that those days you can't be here, obviously with just 10 people, not many can be here, but we'll continue to live stream those masses and participate. And for those, who wouldn't be comfortable yet getting out and coming to Mass, even with just 10 people there, they'll be able to participate still through that live stream. So that'd be something we'll continue to do and to develop and hopefully improve upon as we move forward. But, that's a good sign. Things are moving in that direction. We're going to move very slowly and make sure we do it well. And keep everyone's safety and health concerns in mind, as well as your concern and need for your spiritual nourishment. So continue to pray and join us in that, and we're hoping that we'll have all of that put together and ready to present to you. So if you're watching this on Flocknote, you are signed up for Flocknote, but if you know some in the parish that aren't, maybe forward it to them, encourage them to take a look at it and to sign up for Flocknote, because that's where we're going to be able to kind of push out our information and communication with you in a timely manner and make sure you're up to date on everything that's going on. So keep praying for us. Keep praying for the Lord to intervene and protect all of us, and also to intervene and eradicate this virus from our world so that we can begin to follow Him in those ways that we really need, which is our ability to pray, our ability to receive the sacraments. And that's another thing the Adoration Chapel will probably be able to be opened. And so we'll start looking into how to do that in the best way possible and make sure everyone is protected and safe in that as well. But thanks for all that you're doing and your prayers and your support to the parish. It's overwhelming. You're wonderful, wonderful, wonderful people. And I'm so grateful to be your pastor. And so just keep praying for us and keep encouraging us. It's always a good thing. And we're going to keep praying for you and encouraging you in all that you do. And I hope you have a wonderful evening, and be on the lookout for more information as we get it put together. God bless you.